Greetings viewers, and welcome back to another episode of Pokémon Sacred Gold Egglocke. In today's episode, we are going to be battling the last two members of the Elite Four, which are Bruno and Karen, so I guess we can just get started. I've healed up everyone since the last episode, so no need to worry about that. So we'll just pretty much get on with it. Get our Princess Kazar! And is offering to teleport me, and we're going to go to League Room 3 to battle Bruno, I assume. So we're going to do it in order, even though we could do it in a different order. Yep, there's Bruno. Yeah, we'll start off with Dual Blades, because Dual Blades can hit a Psycho Cutoff and take it out pretty easily. Probably. I am Bruno of the Elite Four. I always train to the extreme because I believe in our potential. That is how we became strong. How can you withstand our power? I see no fear in you. You look determined. Perfect for battle. Ready, Matt? You will bow down to our overwhelming power. Hoo-ha! Obviously, Bruno's got to have his hoo-ha in there, because that's his signature sort of remark, I guess. Anyway, here we are. We are challenged by Elite Four Bruno. Let's go. What's coming out first? Hitmontop. Okay, Hitmontop has fairly low defenses to my knowledge, so a quick Psycho Cut should be enough to take him out. Intimidate, however, might be a bit of an issue. Let's hit with a Psycho Cut and see what he does. Fake out. Damn you, Hitmontop. Damn it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's what you get him on top for trying to flinch me. My speed rises because of Steadfast. Oh yeah. Awesome. And hopefully in one... yeah. There we are. And we'd be in the perfect position for a sweep right now if we hadn't had our attack reduced. I could go for a sword stance, but depending on what comes out next, Hariyama, that's probably got something that's going to take me out. So I'm going to go out to Sweeper, I think. Yeah, why not Sweeper? Sweeper's got that fly for the super effective hit. Super effective hit. And it's obviously shiny, so that's a good bonus. Not at all, really. Anyway, how are you guys today? I'm not too bad myself. Yeah, I'm not really too bad. Had, like, a really boring day at college. Went in. And on Fridays, we have, like, oh, substitute, sub-focus punch. Damn, sub-focus punch, sub-focus punch. Yep, sub-focus punch. Oh, God. You noob, Hariyama, you noob. But yes, went in, and on Friday mornings, first lesson, so first class lesson thing, we always have, like, what's it called, enrichment, which is basically like a random, it's like generally stuff you need to do for life, but no one needs to learn for life because we already know it. Stuff like, maybe, or about social, really, like social rather than being academic stuff. Ooh, yeah, my leftovers are going to help me out there, because then it means we can survive another one. I guess we have to go for another fly, so hopefully he doesn't go for another substitute, because that would suck. But yeah, we have stuff like, last week I think we did like, substitute again, really? Fucking hell, you twat. Yes, anyway, I can't remember what, yeah. But we do stuff like, talking about debating issues, I guess, and stuff like that. But this today, earlier this morning, it was about sexual health. So, you know, I thought, well, I'd heard about it before, I heard about a day or two before, so I thought, should be boring, but, you know, I'll go, you know, may as well. So, I had a tutor interview before that as well, so I just went along and talked to my tutor for a bit. Then, well, as I walked into school as well, I walked past the hall where, you know, obviously the assembly sort of presentation takes place, and I happened to see that there were pretty much dildos on the table. Just dildos, not like dildos, but like, just sort of stood up. Penises, I guess. Sounds really weird, I know, but that's basically what it was. Oh, what do we do here? What do we do? I guess we go dual blades then. Yes, where was I? But yeah, basically that. So I thought, I'm really not gonna, you know, I thought, I don't know. And so I texted my best friend's girlfriend. Don't jump to conclusions, guys, come on. I'm not like that. Anyway, but yeah. I'm obviously good friends with my best friend's girlfriend, otherwise I wouldn't have actually texted her. Anyway, I said, are you coming in today? Because usually she's like late for assembly and stuff like that and just generally doesn't go. So I thought I'd text her and see. And she's like, no, I'm not feeling very well. I'm going to stay home. So, okay. What about Matt? Who's my best friend. So I'm not talking about myself. Not talking about myself. My best friend is also called Matt. Bit weird, I know. But anyway. So yeah, I texted her. Asked her if Matt was coming in as well or if he was just going to, you know, Skype like her. And she said, oh no, he's going to stay back as well, so come here. So I was like, okay, fine. So I just went, oh, earthquake. Doesn't get stabbed from it, so we should be able to deal with it. But yeah, so I went to her house and hung out there, and I had the double free next as well, because my teacher wasn't in. And then in the afternoon, I had a mock, but my teacher last period wasn't in, so I only had like an hour and a half less in the afternoon rather than 2 hours. So really, I went to her house, stayed there for three or four hours, went to my mock, and then went back to her house again, and then my best friend took me home. So that's how it worked. So that was it was a terrible day at school, didn't technically have any lessons at all. Hitmonchan's coming in, so it's time for us to switch out. See, trouble about sending Tipdock or Purin is they're weak to Earthquake, so I'm gonna... why am I sending Band in? This is terrible of me. Idiot, aren't I? Idiot. No point using Sucker Punch because they're going to resist it like hell. May as well go for that Dizzy Punch. It's probably going to hit us with like a submission or, I don't know, close combat possibly and take us out in one. High jump kick, and it missed! Boom! Kept going, crashed. Nice one. And it killed itself! Oh! Get owned, Hitmonchan! Get the fuck owned! We would have taken it out with... I don't know if we'd have survived the high jump kick, but if we did, we'd have just taken it out with a power-up punch. Not a power-up punch. Dizzy Punch, that's the one. Okay, I'm going to send Tipdock out for Machamp here. I'm not sure if Machamp has Earthquake or not. Majority of them actually carry Earthquake, like half of his team. Earthquake or Rock Slide, which really sucks. But we'll see how we go. I think we'll be able to survive one attack. So let's go for Flamethrower. I'm not going to go for Sunny Day Flamethrower. It would take far too long. And as I said, I might not be able to survive more than one attack. So, best to get damage off now. And, okay, half. And it's got Citrus Berry. Damn. God the fuck damn. Stone Edge. Oh, it missed. So I know he has Stone Edge now, but I'm not going to bother to switch out because I think we can survive one Stone Edge. And there's still no guarantee of Stone Edge actually hitting, so... I think we're getting that getting down to red this time, if I'm correct. Yep, Stone Edge again, missed again. Oh, so he's gonna heal up. So I'm gonna go for a Sunny Day, just so I can get that Sunny Day Flamethrower off. I don't think a Sunny Day Flamethrower will actually kill him though, so I'm probably gonna have to still go for the two-hit kill. So it's probably a bad choice overall, but could come helpful if we still decided to stay in. I don't know what else he has on his team. See, Flamethrower, go. Let's see how much damage this does. At least half, because that's what we're doing just now, I'd hope at least. Okay, so yeah, it didn't take him out like I predicted. And Stone Edge, I predicted we survived that, but we'll have to see, won't we? Come on, Tipdock, come on, Tipdock, come on, yes, you did. Yes, boy. Sunlight strong, we're faster, hit with another Flamethrower, and that'll be him gone. And health points, not, well, he'll take us out with one more attack. Unless he's got Mark Punch, I don't see him taking us out, nope. Not at all. Not at all. Goodbye, Machamp. Nice to know you. Nice knowing you. So, obviously, because the sun's up, we won't be able to send out Wolverine, because its water-type moves will be reduced, but we're not going to send Wolverine out anyway, because it's weak to fighting-type moves. That'd be a stupid move, so... What is coming out next? We could keep Tipdock in to get benefit from the sun, but we don't know. Lucario. Definitely staying in here. I think... am I faster than Lucario, though? I don't quite know. I'm going to use a Hyper Potion first, just because I don't know if I'm going to be faster than Lucario or not. I probably don't, I don't know. We'll have to find out next turn, won't we? I'm hoping we can survive one attack with him, though. I mean, always probably got his close combat, so... Extreme Speed. Okay, he's going to be faster than me there anyway, but that's not going to do a huge amount of damage. Because he doesn't get stabbed from it, and we're resisting it pretty well. He says. Yeah, we took that pretty well, in my opinion. Sunlight still round, which is good. Hit it with a Flamethrower, and that'll be Lucario dealt with. So, good game, Bruno, good game. Oh, we're faster, okay, cool. Probably could have taken him on the last turn then, but... No harm in being safe. Better safe than sorry. Better safe than sorry indeed. Goodbye, Lucario. I'm guessing you'll die. Yep, you are. You didn't die, a bit of an embarrassment, but... Oh, well. Actually, no, wait. Yeah, it's a good thing we healed up, because otherwise... He would have hit us with that extreme speed, and we would have died. So that's a good thing. Good thing, me. Why? Why? How could we lose? Etc. Come on, Bruno. Let's do your talking. Having lost, I have no right to say anything. Go face your next challenge. Very rude there, Bruno. Okay, let's heal up everyone else. Dual blades, sweep out, and Tipdock. Yeah. Now, I think last is... Yeah, last is Karen, who is a dark-type user. And she has a bulky Umbreon, I know. I think that's what majority of people were saying in the comment section last episode when I asked... sort of what people's favourite Johto Elite Four person was. So yeah. So let's see. I'm gonna stay out with you. It's been a while since I've yawned over here. but yeah, it's been I think I'm gonna stay out with Dual Blades because Dual Blades has that Drain Punch. And I, you know, it does resist dark type moves. so it's not going to die from one move I wouldn't expect. So we can stay out for a safe switch, or a safe, you know, takeout. I am Karen of the Elite Four. Your match, how amusing. I love Dark-type Pokemon. I know of my overpowering tactics. Think you can take them? Just try to entertain me. Let's go. Very solemn there, Karen. Let's go. Let's go. Not, let's battle to the death. Let's go. Okay, Karen, let's do this. Umbreon or Mightyena's first? Mightyena, I'm sorry, but you're gonna die. You're just gonna so die. It might, okay, Intimidate. Why is it always Intimidate? I'm gonna Sword Stance, actually, because I don't think Mightyena's gonna be able to take me down one hit, or at least, you know, get me down over half, so I'm just gonna use a Sword Stance. Ah, Tracks, really? Really? Really, Mightyena? Okay, we have the Drain Punch. Hopefully we hit there, and it'll be a definite takeout there. Yes, Drain Blades. No, Dual Blades. Get it right, mate, get it right. So that's Mightyena done, if it just drains down all the way, hopefully. I mean, it's super effective, 7 levels higher, and I've had 2 attack boosts, so, yeah. What's coming out next, then? Probably, like, a Dark Ghost type Sableye. Honchkrow, okay. We have Earthquake, but that's not going to help for Honchkrow. We're going to get... Actually, I'm going to stay in it. I'm confident we can take it out with one Drain Punch, thanks to the attack boost here. But I might be wrong. We are faster, which is good. Hopefully it takes that in one, but we won't know for sure until it actually stops. No, that would be helpful. Okay, it's going to go down all the way to... Yes! Nice one, me. Even a Honchkrow couldn't take me out. I was predicting like a Sableye or a Spiritomb for that, you know, ghost immunity to fighting type moves, but apparently not. So, Absol's coming out. I should go for another Drain Punch here. I think I can sweep here. I'm confident I can sweep. Pressure, not going to matter too much if you're going to take one move. So, yeah. Good game, Absol, good game. Once it all goes down, it's level 52 for God's sake, it's even lower level than the Mightyena, so without a doubt, that thing's gone. It's so dead. I don't want to sweep, I always do this, so I don't want to, yeah, so that is the Spiritomb, so I can't do anything now. Sweep, obviously there's nothing, Spiritomb doesn't have any weaknesses in this game, so all we're doing here is just sort of choosing a Pokemon that's a bulky Pokemon, I guess. Send Shumu out. Even though Spiritomb might have Thunderbolt, which I just noticed, or just remembered, so... I don't know. We'll have to see. Yeah, I was about to say, I don't want to sweep with Gallade, because I don't like sweeping with one Pokemon for a battle. Should I hail it? No, we'll just go straight for Surf. Don't want to hail it. Just want to go for the Surf. She's already used her Flying-type Pokemon, so... Blizzard's not going to be too handy, I don't think. Nasty Plot. Okay, raising your special attack there, Spiritomb. So I'm just going to go for the Surf. In the face, Spiritomb, in the face! And you're dead. And you're so dead. Maybe if you had Shadow Sneak, you might have been able to do anything. But, do something. Critical hits, lovely. Shumu gained the experience points. Umbreon, there's the bulky Umbreon. There is the bulky Umbreon. Too bad Dual Blade has now lost its boosts. I'm gonna get a Band. Band is gonna go out and use that Hammer Arm. It's already slow and... Oh, it's a fairly fast Pokemon. It's probably might be faster than the Umbreon since it's higher level, but... I think the speed's not going to matter too much here. Yep, we're faster, and we missed the Hammer Arm, unfortunately. Double team. Oh, come on! Karen! Don't you do this to me! I've already had one bad experience with double team in this Nuzlocke. Slash Egglocke, slash Lock, or whatever. I don't think I have any 100% move. Aha! Time to go out to Shumu. Thank you, Shumu, for being useful. We're going for a Hail Blizzard. Hail Blizzard. Toxic, and it missed. Hail time. I'm hoping it doesn't have anything good against me. I don't know what would be good against me anyway. Thunderbolt. Fighting type move, something like that. Double team again. We don't give a damn, Umbreon. We do not give a damn. Because we have that Blizzard. That Blizzard. Hail's falling, which is actually going to help us out, because you're going to take some damage there, Umbreon. Which is only a bit, but still. Blizzard is not going to do a huge amount of damage, because Umbreon is a special defender, I think. Or is it physical defense? I'm not sure. I think it's special. Yeah, special. Toxic, don't really care too much there. Now he's going to get hit by some more hail now, and I think then if we hit with another blizzard, then the hail will then take him out the turn after. So I think we're safe to go for another blizzard for the takeout. I'm not going to use it to heal myself. Actually, no, wait. Yeah, we'll heal ourselves up first, and then he's going to take some more blizzard damage, or hail damage rather, and then we're definitely going to take him out. So yeah. What's he going for next? Protect. Okay, we're going for Protect anyway, so good, good. Now, because the Protect failed, we've had this problem last episode, I think. Because the Protect failed, it means you can actually use Protect again, doesn't matter. whereas he should really not be able to use that at all, because he just used it technically, even though there weren't any attacks coming to him. Anyway, there it goes. Goodbye, Umbreon. Goodbye. It wasn't even her strongest Pokemon, so... What's next? What's next, indeed? It is... Houndoom. Houndoom. Hello, Houndoom. How are you doing today? I'm going to go to Titduck for this one, because it's got Cross Chop, which is going to do a lot of damage to that Houndoom. And it resists the fire type, so that's good. It's all good. Is Houndoom her strongest Pokemon? Well, one of the strongest, I guess. This is far from being backed into a corner. Really? Oh, Intimidate again. So many Intimidates here. Cross Chop time. Dark Pulse is coming out. I think it's still hailing, so we should be able to take that fairly well. Yeah, we did. We flinched. Oh, come on. Come on. Too bad we don't have Steadfast like Gallade does. Too bad indeed. Nasty plotting now. Okay, that's bad. Hopefully we hit the Cross Chop this turn, though. Yeah, we were pretty lucky last episode, so I was thinking there, has my luck run out now? Because obviously we had the flinch then, and then we might have had the attack missing there, but no. Oh, so close. So damn close. Citrus Berry is going to heal him up a bit. I think even with that Nasty Plot boost there, we'll still be able to take one more Dark Pulse, so I'm going to stay in and not heal up or whatever. Especially since Leftovers just come up. You're no ordinary trainer to have gotten this far. Indeed we're not, Karen. We're awesome. And we're faster, and there goes the Cross Chop, and Houndoom is dead. D-E-A-D. Dead. Or just fainted, technically. Just fainted. There we go. Houndoom fainted. Titduck gained experience points, and we defeated Leaf for Karen. Well, aren't you good? I like that in a trainer. Indeed I am good. Strong Pokemon. Weak Pokemon. That is only the selfish perception of people. Truly skilled trainers should try to win with their favourites. I like your style. You understand what's important. Keep moving. The champion is waiting. Okay, guys. So, there's our Alakazam to take us to the champion. In the next episode of my Sacred Gold Egglocke, we shall be battling the champion of the Johto region, Lance. We could have made this episode a bit longer by battling the champion now. But I'd rather have the finale, or the mid-finale. Mid-season finale. in one episode on its own. So, yeah. Anyway, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Sorry it's a bit shorter, but who cares, really? Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I shall see you next time. Goodbye, my friends.